Hello friends, today we are going to discuss on the role of yoga in mental health, which is the most important aspect of everybody's life. When it comes to mental health, even though there is a lot of awareness these days about mental health, we are neglecting it in some or the other way. Even though we know that we have to focus on it, we are neglecting on it. So how do we improvise, or how do we work on our mental health with yoga practice is what we're going to discuss today. So what affects our mental health? Usually it's our own thoughts, our own expectations, our own emotions that will create some sort of a disturbance in the mind. So in yoga they say it is the chitta vrittis, which means the mental modifications, the ups and downs in our thought process, our emotions, our expectations, our feelings. All of these will create those ripples of these thoughts and emotions will create the disturbance, and that will lead to eventually, it's not that one day there's a ripple and that causes mental illness, but eventually on a long run, these are the main causes of mental diseases or illness. So yoga is defined as yoga chitta vritti nirodha, which means these mental modifications are very much controlled and managed by practice of yoga. So what are the mental illnesses or psychiatric illnesses that we see? Very common is anxiety, depression, which can lead to loneliness. Socially we stop becoming, we isolate ourselves from the society, from the family. There are also a lot of other complex diseases, mental illnesses like schizophrenia, bipolar, and yoga is definitely helpful in all of these conditions. You can read out a lot of scientific research studies that are done by very big institutions in the country and abroad about how yoga helps, how yoga will help you manage your mental illness. If we understand from the scientific perspective, there are a lot of neurochemicals in our body that are released because of any stress response, any anxiousness, loneliness, going into lower mood states. So all of these neurochemical changes that happen in the body can be managed well by yoga practices, because yoga practices also will release or also will regulate the neurochemical changes in the body. It'll start helping us release happy hormones in our own biology, in our own body, that will help us maintaining our moods, maintain our mental status. Okay, so with anxiety, somebody who's very anxious, there are a lot of physical symptoms as well. There's going to be increased heart rate, sweating, restlessness, one cannot sit in a place, lot of racing thoughts, and all of these can be very well slowed down and managed with awareness, and of course and that happens with yoga practice, right? So when somebody is depressed, low mood states, how can we activate them? There are a lot of practices designed specifically for depression. Making them do Surya Namaskara in the way that they should doesn't mean that everybody with depression starts practicing Surya Namaskara without any awareness on it, or without anybody teaching you how to do it. But learning it the right way will help you stimulate your thought process, which will help you pull you out of that well that you have created for yourselves. Most of the time in depression we want to sit in one corner of the room, or always sleep, no mood to eat, no mood to do anything, even things that we like the most we would not want to do it. So all of these things is where it's like the dead battery of the phone or a laptop, right? So how do we recharge it, how do we stimulate it? Is we should do it the right way, right? So we should do it the way which is not very extreme. So yoga practice is going to help you with that. And in a lot of advanced cases who are on medications, yoga is going to help in integration. Yoga is a very good complementary therapy. Doesn't mean somebody with psychiatric illness stop taking medicines and start doing yoga. That's not what we are trying to convey here. Medicines are very, very necessary. When they are given to you, it is necessary. But practicing yoga along with taking medicines will help you manage yourselves better. So that way, yoga is going to help in calming down ourselves. Or in basically balancing ourselves, rather than calming down, I would say balancing ourselves, harmonizing ourselves physically and as well as mentally. So that way you'll be able to stay fit. That's the new term now, stay fit mentally as well as physically. So start yoga practice for therapy, especially for mental illness or mental health. You should approach a yoga doctor to learn yoga techniques the right way. So learn it from the right person and practice it the right way. I hope this was a helpful video. You received the information that you were looking for. Please subscribe to our channel for more such videos on health, physical health, mental health. Please put your questions and comments in our comment section, and we will get back to you the earliest that we can. Thank you.